We are going to discuss on C sharp Windows from Visual Studio Chapter 3. That is how to use button to display the input of text box on Windows form. So here we are opening Visual Studio. As it is open, we have our form open. This form is open. Now we are going to import a control, that is button control. The control that when it is added to our form, we are going to click it and have our input from text box displayed on the form. Next, we are importing control, another control, that is text box, and we use multiline function attached to it in such a way that we can enlarge it, and we copy it and paste. By copying and paste, now we are trying to see that we move them all together and arrange them. Next thing to do is we are going to look at label that we have to also import it onto our form. These two labels are on our form, therefore they are going to be responsible for displaying the content, that is the input of our text boxes. So here we are going to change the font size of the label, therefore the result will going to be big in size. We are going to do that for the label 2 also. Then next thing to do is we have to delete the text property of the labels. Therefore, when we are running the form, it is going to look empty while the label is there. Then here we are changing the font text property to display content. After we change it, then next we have to enlarge the font. The font have to look big in such a way that it will be accommodated on the form. Now we are changing the size to be 13, and we are also activating bold property. Next thing to do is we have to change the back color of the form totally. Therefore, all our controls on the form will look nice. So we just go to back, click on it and select the color of your choice. That's it. Now, after everything is ready, that is user interface, here we double click on the button and see ourselves arrive on the coding environment. Here you can see private void button 1. Click. Then here we are creating a string variable. This string variable is a type of variable that is string. We give it a name of t1. Then we were assigning a value of textbox1.text. With that, mean whatever is goes into textbox1.text is going to be inside this variable t1. Then another variable is integer type variable, that is t2, which is equals to integer.parse. We are saying integer.parse because textbox always contains string. So we have to change the format of the, we have to convert it from, that is textbox2.text. So now we have created a variable with t1 and t2, then we assign value to them. Next is we have a label1.text. That means the text property of the label 1 is going to be the content of t1. Likewise, the text property of label 2 is going to be the content of t2. But this time around, it is not going to be 2u2. We have to convert it to string because the integer type there is, this variable type there is integer. Okay, so that is all. Next, we are just going to run it. When we run it, now I'm inputting some values into the text box. Here I have Abdullah in the text box 1 because it contains string. Then the other text box I have numbers, that is whole numbers. Then I click on display, it is displaying the content of the text box for me on the phone. So far so good. This is how to use a button to display the content of text box on a phone. Follow us on the next tutorials to have many tutorials based on C# Windows Form application. See you. Bye-bye.